everyone, welcome back to Shruta's Universe. In this video, I'm gonna show you how I painted cherry blossom on a muslin silk fabric. So let's get started. I've started painting with some branches and going to add the flowers later. This is a really sweet lavender colored fabric, and I'm going to use similar colors for this painting. After drawing some random branches with a dark purple, I've picked up some white paint, and the paint kind of mixes with the previous dark purple and creating a shade so that our painting doesn't appear flat. Let's start painting some beautiful flowers. For the first one, I've picked the dark purple from our branches and just simply painting a flower that has 5 petals. Don't worry, we're going to add the details later. For the next flower, I've mixed some white with the previous color and prepared a lavender color. I'm using a white paint to detail the purple flower and some dark purple for the lavender one. If your paint is too liquid and running down like mine, then don't worry, just mix it back together. You can fix almost every mistakes you are doing with your paintbrush. Now adding some details at the edges of the flower. Not on both sides, we're just doing it in one side. So this is how our final flower looks. Our next flower is a pink one. I've already told you we're going to keep the color similar to the cloth. You can paint and shade at a time, or you can paint the flower entirely and then shade. It depends on you. As you may have already noticed, we are using a dark color for the detailing of the light flowers and vice versa for the dark ones. Here comes the most favorite one of mine, which is a white little flower in the middle of all these colorful ones. You can see I have added some light purple shades on the first white flower. This painting is not completely realistic. Just pour all of your imaginations with the realistic forms of the flowers. Paint as many flowers as you want around the branches. After painting some flowers, I'm going to show you a really fun part of the painting. A fun part which is realistic and magical at the same time. So keep watching. If you're working on a standing frame like me, then you have to be a bit careful about the runny liquid paints like this dark purple one. That's because they can easily run down and ruin your painting. Painting wet on wet is kind of beautiful. The paints gets blended nicely together and creates beautiful shades. Here comes the fun part. For this, you just need a random toothbrush and your paints. We're going to spray our paint with the toothbrush, and for this the paint should be fairly liquid. Firstly, we are spraying with white paint. And Don't worry about the big chunks of paints while you spray. Just tap on it lightly and kind of blend it with the cloth. And this is the part of the painting. Everything does not have to be equal and even. Instead, it will make it look more natural. Okay, the next color we are spraying with is the dark purple, followed by some pink. And look how pretty our flowers look after the spray paint. We are not finished yet. We are yet missing on some important parts. Can you make a guess what are those? Our flowers don't look complete without some buds, right? So we are adding them now. Add as much as you want. Again, this depends completely on you. Start drawing them with white and then add some shades. We are almost done now. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, then please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. I hope to see you on the next one.